I couldn't resist the chance to come back and visit the old crumbling ruins and see how the hotel was doing as well.
The movie's favorite geezers are back, and that is cause for celebration. In this sequel, Maggie Smith is now, as Muriel, the co-manager of the exotic Marigold Hotel and looking to expand into a companion hotel with her co-manager, the young, irrepressible, and irresistible Sonny. The two go to San Diego, actually, looking for backers for their prospect. And as the movie goes along, they run into plenty of competition and complications as plans for the second hotel unfold. Also unfolding are the various stories of the various residents here of the exotic Marigold Hotel, particularly Judi Dench and Bill Nighy, who are looking for work in India, and also possibly romance. And there's many other storylines, perhaps too many. The film goes back and forth, but it is so much fun and very entertaining to watch all of these people go about their way. It's like revisiting old friends. And into this mix comes, hey, say it ain't so, Richard Gere.
Lordy, Lord, have mercy on my avarice.
He's not old enough for this, is he? Well, he plays an author looking for inspiration who comes there, but he may also be a spy checking out how good this hotel is for the corporation who may be investing.
He's the one.
What one?
Our evaluator, sent to decide if we are to be franchise or footnote.
At any rate, Richard Gere is also a welcome presence, but a surprising one, I think, in this film. But he fits right in. The cast is just superb. You cannot go wrong with Maggie Smith and Judi Dench. I mean, these two are icons, and they are having the time of their lives in this movie. Bill Nighy, I also would point out, it's great to have them back. I highly recommend this, particularly for grown-ups. Here's a movie that you can go to, but don't stay away, young people. This one's for you too. To everyone, check in to the second exotic Marigold Hotel. I say go.